Let me start by saying what I believe it's obvious already, that Iran is a very complex country. There are usually people speak about Iran in terms of black and white, but there are many, many colors in between. There are many groupings, there are many different tendencies, and there are even different basic ideological differences between groups, not only in terms of more pragmatic or more extremist, but also in terms of the basic ideology of Islam, how Islam should be interpreted, implemented, and if the ideology that runs this regime is purely Islamic, or what I think we can see recently is more mixture of religion and nationalism. The tradition of the Persian empires now mixing with ideology, but both of them think that Iran is a superpower. Iran is the major power in the Middle East. I say here in parentheses that the Iranian strength, the power that we see in Iran today in the region, is not entirely because of the West or because of religion. Please treat the Iranians more seriously. They have a great educational system, science, technology, advanced. The world did not allow them to buy, they produced and they learned. And I think that Iran should not be dismissed as a third world backward country. They have also history, heritage of running a state, culture, and many other strengths that they have. Trump threatened that if they would fire American drones or whatever in the Gulf, he will react. What happened? They shut down sophisticated drone, and what happened? Nothing. Then on the top of it, both of them, rightly from perspective of the United States possibly, they say they want to go out of this region. And they already started to retreat. How you keep your relations with your allies? What you say to Saudi Arabia and also to Israel? When America is withdrawing, that's add to the Iranians' chutzpah, and they can demand more. So that's not for Iran. Israel is an easy enemy. To claim leadership of the Muslim world, they have to raise the flag of Jerusalem, and they are doing it very seriously. And it's not only the ideological side of it, because they Islamized the conflict with Israel. It's now Hamas is doing it with Jerusalem. But they are now around the borders of Israel. They are in Gaza, they are in Lebanon, they are in Syria. And even in Yemen, Israel has interest because of much of our imports, both from the seas.